Late night rant. Anyway, I don't even know if anybody even gives a shit or anymore here in America, but what's going on up in Canada? And then, you know, the revelations of the Durham came out and said, basically, you know, the Hillary campaign spied on Trump and spied on him while they were in the White House. You can go research that. I mean, it's on Fox News, Max, Breitbart, you know, everywhere but the mainstream media, of course. But after Russia for 4 years. But I think everybody needs to exercise their constitutional rights and not listen to all that, you know, mainstream media bullshit. And I know I'm tired of 2 years, you know, 2 years of doing this, and I'm getting exhausted, you know, trying to cover all this stuff. But I feel it's my duty as an American to do what I can to, you know, at least put out the information. Anyway, but this is like take two. I did a take earlier, and I'm like, I got too pissed off in it. But yeah, I just think, you know, Americans need to get off their ass, and you know, we're gonna have a communist country. Could be up in Canada. I mean, they're seizing bank accounts and canceling people's, you know, insurance without truckers or anybody. Looks like anybody that supports, you know, the movement up there that's going on in Canada, which is absolutely amazing. A lot of the on-ground reporting is absolutely just great, amazing. Kudos to them. And, you know, what do we do here in America? We're too busy. Well, Canadians are driving from the West Coast, Northern Alberta, Manitoba. They're driving, you know. Freaked me out today. Some guy said he drove 3,200 kilometers to get there. I'm like, wait a minute, I got to do math now. But they're making a sacrifice, and they're, you know, taking time off work, or, you know, and they're not getting paid. These truckers aren't getting paid. And now they want to, you know, take money away that, you know, people are donating to them. I mean, it's crazy. And I mean, it's just amazing that, you know, they're, you know, this could happen here in America. I'm sorry. And, you know, I've been saying that for 2 years, but nobody gives a shit. So I guess I'm just, you know, talking to a hand as usual. But, yeah, exercise your constitutional rights. Know your constitution, know your state constitution. Go read the Federalist Papers. And if you don't know, I did a series on my old channel before I got struck down by YouTube on the Federalist Papers. And then I think they're probably down there somewhere in all my videos that I continue to do out here on this channel. But, you know, I'm hearing so many people that they're just, like, so frustrated they're giving up. And I'm not going to give up. I was going to take a break, but, you know, it's time for the younger generation to step up. And there's a couple people I know that are younger. It's time for you to step up, make a sacrifice, you know, get involved, do something. And yeah, it's just crazy. I mean, I'm glad the world's finally working, you know, they're waking up, but, you know, it may be too late, in my opinion. We may have to fight after tyranny hits instead of fighting tyranny before it is here. So, just my opinion. Opinion of the host, nobody else's. I don't even know if this is even worth it, but I don't know. I got kind of pissed off today, and, you know, trying to take a break, but saw what was going on up in Canada today, and, you know, what the Trudeau government up there did today, and it just kind of pissed me off, so. Anyway, I don't know. And I'm not seeing too many Americans speak out, you know, speak out or speak up. I mean, what happened to all these rumors that, you know, oh, they're going to blockade the Super Bowl and stuff. And, you know, why are they waiting until March 1st to start a convoy? I mean, they're going to go to The West Coast are going to meet in Coachella, California, I guess, on March 1st and then drive. Why wait? You know, I mean, if you're going to do it now, which I don't agree. And like I've said before, I don't agree going to the Capitol because, you know, that's not going to do much other than, you know, have the mainstream media, which most Americans watch, saying that, you know, it's an insurrection and like they're doing up in Canada. It's you gotta go to your state capitals, you know, and there's not much going here on here in Oregon, Washington. There's no protests out there, you know, like free Palestine. Well, how about let's go out there and protest free Canada? No, crickets as usual. I mean, it's just depressing that Americans are so damn, you know, distracted, lazy, uninformed, and you know, even the people that you talk to, sometimes they're like, "Oh no, I'm not gonna take time to go read that, and I'm not gonna do that. No, that's not what I know." It's like, hey, open your mind, people. Go look at all points of view. Come on, look at all points of view. See where the real truth is coming from. I mean, yeah, so, you know. I pray every day, man, that, you know, America's gonna, I mean, it's nice as people are starting to wake up, but, you know, I just think that we're gonna have to fight tyranny after it takes over and not, you know, fight against tyranny before it happens. So, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, I'm gonna probably try to take a break this week. I don't know if it's going to happen because I'm go, and, you know, even when I want to take a break, I see something, and I'm like, well, at least my mom's going to know about it, you know, and then she can spread the word. So, anyway, peace out, guys. Have a good night, and have a good week. See ya.
What's the matter with you?
I guess I just can't take it, sir.
What did you say?
It's my nerves, sir. I just can't stand the shelling anymore.
Your nerves? Hell, you're just a goddamn coward.
Shut up!
We'll have a yellow bastard sitting here crying in front of these brave men who've been wounded in battle. Shut up! Don't admit this yellow bastard. Nothing wrong with him. We won't have sons of bitches who are afraid to fight stinking up this place of honor. You're going back to the front, my friend. You may get shot, you may get killed, but you're going up to the fighting. Either that or I'm going to stand you up in front of a firing squad. I ought to shoot you myself, you goddamn bastard. Get him out of here! Send him up to the front! You hear me? You goddamn coward!
In this present crisis, government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem.
Have you noticed that as everything around you seems to decline, one thing still grows? It is the power of your rulers. None of their plans and directives have solved your problems or made your life better. The only result has been their increased control over you at the cost of your freedom. Do you know why? You gave them the power.